you know, how I can define this taste. Ah. There is a great romance between this kurpi and the kadai, and the result is just love, the love of good food. The finger licking good of brown onion, potato, kulcha, of course topped with little bit butter, and having it with paneer kadai matar, I'm telling you, this is just outstanding. Imagine the double dose of butter in the kadai paneer, kasuri methi, and this butter, and this kulcha with little bit butter. This is going to be just too good. You know how I can define this taste. Ah. Namaste, salam alaikum, sasriyakal. Welcome back to another session with your Vahchef at vareva.com. And today we're going to learn how to make kadai matar paneer. We're going to use the real kadai here. First, we're going to make the kadai masala. And you know, we're going to use 7 spice powder, not 5 spice like Chinese. Just for fun, I'm saying you're going to use all spice. You know, we got use cloves and cardamom, cinnamon, and coriander seeds. Add fennel seeds and some cumin seeds. In a kadai spice, you know, in each area it is different. You can use your own spices. You're going to take some black pepper and add to this. So here, the black cardamom, I'm going to use it, you know, in the gravy. The slow dry roasting of the ingredients will bring out the nice flavor of these ingredients. So once they are pounded, we're going to add it, you know, almost when the gravy is cooked, and then this gives a very nice flavor. Do not burn any of the ingredients on a slow flame. Cook them till the nice aroma is out. So here, all the coriander seeds, everything is getting cooked, and transfer this onto a plate, and we're going to let this cool down. Once all these things are cooled down, we're going to put in a pestle, ding chick, ding chick, ding chick, and then we're going to do ding chick of these ingredients, and we're going to add it in the last. In the kadai, we're going to add some oil, and we're going to get my favorite kurpi. You know, I'm known for this in the college. I'm not going to tell what it is, not a worthy story to tell. Here, we're going to add black cardamom. So the red chilli, break it into pieces and add to this. Let these red chillies slightly sizzle in the oil. The nice flavor from the red chillies come out. Kadai means full of flavors. You know, that's how we're going to cook this. These red chillies also start turning out the color. In this, we're going to add finely chopped onion. The moment I add onions, I also add some salt. We're going to saute these onions till they are slightly golden, because you want a very nice gravy, and this gravy is going to be red and full flavorful. When you cook in a kadai, the entire ingredients, because you see the larger area, all the masalas get roasted. Even any powders you add, they get nicely roasted, and the ingredients also get, you know, slightly cooked. You keep scraping, 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 and that gives very good taste. Think about that buna chicken and all those things. In this, we're going to add ginger garlic paste. Look at this, the onions, you know, getting nicely golden, and that too evenly getting colored. That is what we can achieve in a kadai. In this, we're going to add turmeric, tomatoes, put in a blender, make a puree, and then we're going to add the tomato puree. This tomato puree needs to be cooked. See, when you're cooking in a normal vessel, it takes a lot more time, and in a kadai, because the surface area is a lot more, it gets cooked much faster. In this, we're going to add chilli powder. I suggest you use Kashmiri chilli powder, because that gives a very nice red color. So here, nice Kashmiri chilli powder, and mix it well. Then you can start seeing some oil coming from this. That means the gravy is ready. Now in this, we want to get a very nice gravy. And I've shown you another recipe where I've used roasted chickpea flour. And here, I'm going to use cashew nut powder. But instead of adding cashew nut powder in the gravy, I'm going to add it in this. See, move the masala on the side, and on the other side, just sprinkle the cashew nut powder, saute it a little bit. Cashew nut thing will get stuck at the bottom, the rawness. We're going to cook like this till it stops sticking at the bottom. You do not want anything to burn. Now the masala is all done. We're going to add water. The cashew nut, everything will be excellent. And do not worry, this will all thicken and become a very nice gravy. The gravy is nice, silky. Add the green peas. This is going to take some few minutes to come to a boil. And a nice green chili or capsicum would be excellent in this. So I'm going to add some green chili. This is nicely getting cooked. We're going to add these masalas. Usually I add a little later, but with the paneer, masala, the seven spices, whatever I added, make it a little bit coarse powder. And to this gravy, the entire flavor, everything will change. And also there is one more thing, kasuri methi, which I'll add. So first in this, we're going to add paneer. In the roadside dabas, you must have seen that they fry the paneer and add. If the paneer is getting a little bit, you know, slimy and all that, they fry it. But if it is fresh paneer, always add fresh paneer into this and it will be good. In this, the magical, the spice is, you know, kasuri methi. Not so much, little bit of kasuri methi, and just put it in between your, you know, palms and make a fine powder of it. So look at this. Kasuri methi is useless if you don't add butter. You know, for me, you don't have to add, but for me, I love to add butter. In this, I'm going to add butter, okay, and add capsicum, and look at the nice gravy. You know, if you want slightly thinner, you can do it, but I love to make it like this. The gravy is ready. The salt, you know, I added perfect. You know, last, when you add the cream, I've already shown you the technique that your cream should not curdle. Take a spoon, take some of the gravy and temper the cream. Tempering means basically you add some of the gravy to the cream and mix it so that it doesn't curdle. Now we're going to add this cream. This is very diluted cream. In this, add it and mix this and just bring it to one boil. This is all perfect. If you want to finish it off by some chopped coriander, that's also fine. The kadai paneer is all ready to be served. And with this, we're going to have, you know, brown onion potato kulcha. Have you ever had it? So this is very tasty. With this, we're going to have that. To make this kulcha, we're going to use all-purpose flour, that is maida, and we're going to add a little bit of yeast. See, in the kulcha, you don't add as much as yeast you add for a bread, but little bit, even in the naan we do. So first, we're going to take yeast and add some warm water. Look at those pearls. They will get dissolved once you add a little bit of warm water. Once these things get dissolved in this, the food for the yeast is sugar. So the moment you add sugar, the yeast start getting active. Because this is dry yeast, we need to make that active. And little bit of this warm water and the yeast. Look at this yeast, it's slowly dissolving into this. And what we do is here, you can make rich dough. Some people love to add an egg, some people add yogurt, milk, whatever you want, you know, you can enrich this mixture and make the dough. You add all-purpose flour into this mixture, make this into a soft dough. I already have a dough because my curry is ready and, you know, the dough is also ready. So I'm going to show you how to make the kulcha with the ready-made dough. Look at the dough. This is nice, soft. I'm going to divide this into a smaller portion because I don't want to make big kulcha. I want to make smaller kulchas and enjoy. We're going to add brown onion and potatoes kulcha. Take the brown onions like this. This much should be good enough because brown onions are very flavorful. I am pretty much known as a biryani boy, so I always have the brown onions ready in my kitchen. You're going to crush the brown onion. In this, we're going to add a little bit of jeera powder. This is the only flavoring that we're going to add with the brown onions. Little bit of salt. In this, we're going to add potato. The potato and brown onion kulcha. Look at the amount of brown onions we are adding. In this, just mix this one. The crunchy onion will become a little bit soft along with this potato mixture. And this is the stuffing that I'm going to use it in my kulcha. You know, this mixture has to be soft. Otherwise, your kulcha will tear and come out. So once you add the onions, everything, you have to... It is very nice sweet onion flavor. And the potatoes, this one I'm going to divide them into four portions for my kulchas. And the size of the stuffing should be same as that as a dough mixture. To make this kulcha, you know, sprinkle some flour because this is very, very sticky. Flatten the dough. See, this is nice and sticky. So that's how it should be. Put the onions, potato stuffing in the center, seal the edges. And do not be in a hurry, roll them off. Once you do the stuffing, then slowly the potato, spread it with your hand. You don't need to roll them. If you want, you can just put it on the table, make it with the hand, that should be good enough. I do not want big size kulchas. I want them to be nice, small and round, and this will come out super tasty. Cook it on the both sides. Later we're going to add butter on top. Just move it on the side and dust off any extra flour. We're going to add another one. You know, once you put it on the stove, they will slightly puff up a little bit. These kulchas are come out good. We're going to add butter. Cook well on both sides. And then, this is puffing up good. Once you have this fantastic kulchas, then we're going to serve it with the curry. Kulchas are all ready. And we have this hot kadai paneer. And when you put it on a nice white plate, you will see this beautiful color of this gravy. That is why this is called kadai paneer, because of a very nice flavor of the capsicum and everything in this gravy. Always, you know, I love to add a little bit of butter on top. While this butter melts, kadai paneer will become even more tasty. Look at the kulchas. The kulchas have to be nice and light. Inside, the stuffing is extraordinary. I'm going to tear one kulcha and I'm going to open it. It's so hot. The nice brown onion and the stuffing. Anybody can cook. Just follow the recipe. Very simple. Just follow step by step and your curry will be excellent and your family will be crazy about your food. Make these curries at home and you will obviously, you will say, whatever. Every bite is out of the world. You know how I can define this taste?